Earlier we looked into app module and app component. Now we will understand how app module and app component gets initialized. The Angular application gets initialized using main.ts file available in src folder. Let me open main.ts. We can see that there is no class definition in this file. This means that the lines defined in this TS file will get directly executed in the browser when the Angular application starts. Let us look into the if statement defined. The if statement has the condition environment.production. Here, environment looks like an object since we are referring to the production property using period. The environment object gets imported from line number 5. It comes from environment.ts file from environments folder. Let me expand environments folder and open environment.ts. We can see the environment object is defined with production property as false. Let us now go back to main.ts. Here, as environment.production value is false, then the lines within this if block is not executed. So the function call enable prod mode does not get executed. From the imports, we can see that the function enable prod mode is imported from the built-in Angular library at angular/core. From the if block, we can understand that the Angular application is not running in production mode and it runs in development mode. When the Angular application runs in development mode, when a file is modified in the Angular app, the entire application gets compiled and reloaded. We would have noticed this when we change app.component.html and saved it. The development mode helps to improve the productivity with quick reloads, and we can instantly check the result of the changes made. Hope this gives an explanation for the if block. We will now look into the next lines of main.ts. In line number 11, the function platform browser dynamic and bootstrap module helps to initialize the Angular application by passing the app module as input. Both these functions are imported from at Angular folder, which means that it comes from the Angular built-in library. The line number 12 helps to handle the scenario when loading of Angular application fails. This line will display the error message in the browser console so that we as developers can find the reason for the failure. Hope this explanation gives an understanding about the content of main.ts. In the next video, I will summarize the overall code execution flow when the Angular application starts. We will also look into the summary of Angular architecture based on whatever we have learned so far in the past 10 videos.